So you have this life that can come out of you. Now, that's the one way. Now, I will tell you, that is the weakest way to minister healing. Okay? It's also the weakest way to receive healing, which is by the laying on of hands. It's good because we do get a chance to say, Jesus did this, and really laying on of hands was only meant for unbelievers, technically. Really, laying on of hands was really never meant for believers. And God made a way for all four types of people to get healed because there's only four types of people. You say, how do you know that? Because Jesus gave the parable of the sower, and there's only four types of soil, and those are people. You got that?
Yeah.
So there are four types of soil, and it's not the parable of the sower. It's the parable of the soil, because the purpose of the parable is not about the sower. The purpose of the parable is about the soil that it goes into. So if that's in your Bible, parable of the sower, just mark out sower and put soil, right? It's real simple. And he says that these different types of soil. There's four types of soil, four types of people on the earth. Number one, unsaved. Now, the way God made provision for the unsaved to get healed, Mark 16. Believers lay hands on the sick. Notice, believers are never meant to be the sick. He didn't say believers lay hands on sick believers. See, that was a method of evangelism. You lay hands on the sick, they get healed, they want to get saved. That's the way it's supposed to work. He said, these signs, for who? Signs are not for believers, but for unbelievers. Isn't that right? Now, it also says they'll speak in other tongues. Right? And that sign, even Corinthians tells us, 1 Corinthians 12, 1 Corinthians 14, tells us that tongues are actually for unbelievers. Think about that. But yet, the only place we ever do it is in church, where when we're around a whole bunch of believers. You know, it's like probably Coca-Cola, Pepsi, you know, they probably have been asking you to put their signs up in here. Why? Because they would figure not that they get more visibility out there on the road somewhere. Well, it's the same thing. Signs weren't meant for in church. They were meant for out there.
Yeah.
For the unbelievers. Amen?
Amen?
All right, we'll see. I'm not sure you're convinced yet, but we'll see. All right, so first there's the unbeliever, right? So then the next three categories are all believers. In this sense, all right? The next category is a brand new believer. I mean, they're so new, if you called them carnal, they wouldn't even know you were insulting them. They have no clue. They don't even know at this point, right? But that's out of that would be out of James, James chapter 5. It says, if there's any sick among you, if there be any sick among you, hear that? Any sick among you, let him, that sick person, call for the elders, right, of the church, and they will come to them, and they will anoint them with oil in the name of the Lord, and they will pray over him in the prayer of faith. Notice not the oil, the prayer of faith shall save, heal, deliver the sick. Amen? And if he's committed any sins, they'll be forgiven. Do you see that? Notice it didn't say that they have to confess their sins before they can get healed. It said they get healed first, then they can confess their sins. And even if it doesn't even say they have to confess their sins at that point. But it says that the elders will pray the prayer of faith. Now, this is because this James short book, right, five chapters, it was written predominantly and used, I should say, maybe not written for, but used in the early church as a primer for how to live the Christian life. It's a beginner book of how to live the Christian life. Everything you need to know about how to live the Christian life is right there. It talks about how to treat people, how to watch your mouth, how to confess your faults one to another. I mean, basically everything you need to know on the basics is in the book of James. Number two on that point is it's only five chapters. Most people, when they get them saved, they try to send them to the book of John. Way too thick a book for a brand new believer, right? And it's because they think John will teach them about the love of God and all that. Well, that's what the church and fellowship and discipleship is for. But at this point, they're believers, so they need to learn how to live the life. So they're brand new. Give them a short book. James chapter 5. Read through this. Study this. Watch your mouth. Watch what you say. Don't treat people differently. Somebody comes in dressed real nice. Don't treat them differently than you treat somebody come in dressed not nice. And so he just tells you how to live it. So that's the second person. A brand new Christian, baby Christian. That's the second level. Third level, carnal Christians. How do carnal Christians get healed? Right? So you're with me so far, right? Unsaved, laying on of hands by a believer, right? Brand new saved, doesn't know really much about it, doesn't know how to receive healing, call for the elders. Let them do their job. Which also means if you're an elder, you got to be able to pray the prayer of faith and get people healed. If you can't, you can't be an elder. Isn't that simple? So, doesn't matter if you're the biggest tither. Just saying. Anyway, okay. So, But then you got the carnal believer. Well, how does a carnal believer get healed? 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Corinthians, especially 1 Corinthians, he tells them, he said, you're carnal, you've been carnal, you're still carnal. And he said, chapter 11, he talks about the Lord's Supper. And in the Lord's Supper, he goes through it all and he said, this was what was delivered to me and I'm telling you, Paul writing to the Corinthians, how Jesus was betrayed and how he took the cup and he took the bread first and broke the bread and he said, take, eat, this is my body broken for you. And so then they took the bread and they ate it. Now, when was his body broken for you? At the whipping post. The whipping post, by his stripes, you were healed. So breaking the bread was representative of his body being broken for you. Carnal people, carnal means sense-oriented, so you need something physical to say, at this time, 6:39 p.m. on this day, I ate that bread, and by his stripes I'm healed, because that bread was his body broken for me, and therefore now, and they have something, they have a point of contact that they can attach their faith to so they can be healed, and they set that time. Because they're carnal, they need something physical to attach. So that's how carnal Christians can get healed. Now, nobody wants to admit to being a carnal Christian. That's why when we do the Lord's Supper, we don't, you know, specify. But if you go on through there in about verse 30 and 29 and 30 and 31, he says, for this cause, many of you are weak, sick, and die prematurely. Why? Because you don't discern the Lord's body. He didn't say you don't discern the Lord's blood. Why? Because everybody in the church discerns the Lord's blood. That's how you get saved, by his blood. You know that. But people don't understand about that body and that bread. And they, because of that, he said, because you don't discern it, that's why you're weak, sick, and die prematurely. So if you take, if you partake of the Lord's Supper wrongly, you can remain sick, weak, and die early. So if we got church members that are weak, sick, and dying early, it's because we're not explaining to them how to partake in the Lord's Supper and receive physical healing at that moment. Then he said, after that, he took the cup and said, this is my blood, the cup of my blood, right? He said, for the forgiveness of sins. Now notice, you eat the bread before you drink the cup. You can get healed before you can get saved. Why? Because he bore the stripes before he went to the cross. Yeah. Healing in the atonement. Real simple. This will be in the book, right? So we're talking about, I'm writing a book on that right now. So this is, and that's for carnal believers. So carnal believers can get healed by partaking of the Lord's Supper. Amen? So that only leaves one group of people, spiritual believers. Spiritual believers. How does a spiritually minded believer get healed? Simple. Romans chapter 8. If that same spirit which raised up Christ Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he will quicken your mortal body by that same spirit dwelling in you. You get that? So if you're a spiritually minded believer, you will automatically first say, you know what? Christianity is about me and you. Amen? It's about your direct connection. So you just, Father, I just thank you. By his stripes, I'm healed. And you learn to receive it for yourself. And then you can actually release the Spirit of God out into your flesh. And you get healed. And you don't have to call anybody, go anywhere, get hands laid on you, whatever else. You don't have to do any of that. Why? Spiritually minded believers should have such a communion. Not that it's a high level of communion. You should just know that you are connected. That's all you have to know. If you know you're connected, you got it. Amen. Right? And then you can just receive directly from it. Now, so that's the four ways that God made for any person on this earth to be healed. Amen?